By now, the couple had gone on nearly all the rides, saving the fastest for last.
Right before we got on that roller coaster, I was drinking a frozen lemonade, and I couldn't finish it because it seemed like it was making my stomach hurt more.
The ride had huge drops. It had twists and turns real fast.
You gotta make sure you're tall enough for this ride. You know, you gotta be at least 50 inches.
It's one of those that just goes up and down and turns quickly, and they go fast. It was crazy.
The bar that goes over your lap, it did feel a little bit tighter, but I thought that was just for me having that extra weight. The ride itself, it would jerk you around a lot.
That was fun,
wasn't it? Oh, when we got off the roller coaster, I had mentioned to Armando, my stomach hurts really bad. I don't know if that roller coaster did it or it was drinking that lemonade.
I have really bad cramps, you know, just give me a minute, okay? It's really bad cramps.
I told my mom, maybe we should go home. I just need to go to the bathroom before we go. When I walked into the bathroom, I didn't see anybody in there, but I guess there was another side to that bathroom because that's where the bathroom attendant was.
I had just cleaned the floor. I didn't see Mona when she came in the restroom because there's a wall that separates the two parts of the bathroom.
Honey, are you all right in there?
Oh, I don't think so, Mom.
I kept going by and I'm like, are you okay? And she's like, I'm getting these real sharp pains and they're really hurting. The pain is so hard, I'm not gonna be able to get up. I walked out and I seen my husband. I said, Mona, she's cramping real bad and she can't get up. Can you go see if you can find us a wheelchair?
I was very concerned. I said, wow, it hurts that much that she can't walk?
My mom just thought that I was starting my period. She just thought maybe it was a little bit worse than before.
Meanwhile, I was talking to her boyfriend and I'm like, has she mentioned to you that she's not feeling well? He said, no, she's been fine.
You just get a wheelchair or something up.
I have one right here.
Thank you.
I just thought I was having a bowel movement, but the pain really started to get bad. I didn't have a thought of what was coming out of me. On a scale from 1 to 10, the pain was a 10. I stood up because then I felt like I had to throw up.
When Mona stood, a violent cramp surged through her. Just as suddenly, her body relaxed.
In that short amount of time standing up, there was no more pain. The cramping was gone, the pain in my back was gone, everything was gone.
Then Mona looked down.
Oh my God.
I just had a baby. I couldn't believe it. How could I have a baby in a bathroom? He was laying right there on the floor. I don't know if his head hit first or his little body fell first. He could not be alive. I was scared.
Somebody, please! Somebody help me!
When I heard the screams and I heard, oh my God, I knew something was definitely wrong.
Stay calm, stay calm. I'm gonna get you help.
I looked in the stall and there she was. She was braced against the stall in shock. And there was the baby on the floor. And the baby was very still. The umbilical cord was still attached. Mona was in dire straits. She needed help. So I ran and got help.
I asked them that if I could get a wheelchair. But before I left, the registered nurse suggested, where's your daughter at? Let's go see how she's doing.
As the nurse went to check on Mona, Raphael waited anxiously outside.
She walks in, she runs out to get help, and then the scream like followed her. I said, that's Mona, and then I just went in. The first thing I see is this baby on the cement floor and the cord connected to my daughter, Mona.
Stay calm, I'm gonna go get help. Mona's at the baby in the bathroom.
He's not moving. He's not crying, there's something wrong.
The baby lied there, quiet, still. That picture will never go out of my mind.
I was just imagining that she was hemorrhaging, gushing out blood.
Mona, you had a baby.
baby? I'm so sorry.
The baby wasn't moving. He wasn't crying. I was thinking maybe something was wrong.
I was in shock. I couldn't believe it. He's just laying there. He's cold. You know, he's not wrapped up in anything.
His eyes are wide open, and he's sort of like on his side, and he's just staring at Mona. And I turned around, the paramedics were there. Everybody showed up right away, really quick.
The paramedics cut the umbilical cord and cleared the baby's airways. But the newborn was still silent.
I still hear the baby crying. The paramedics, he's talking to the baby.
We did get you to cry.
And then all of a sudden he cries. I heard this paramedic say, that's all we wanted to hear from you. It's for you to cry.
I was happy that he was crying and moving.
Her facial expression was like scared, afraid, shocked, all combined in one.
They put Mona in the gurney and they had the baby.
I don't remember what happened. I blacked out after that. When I finally woke up, we were in the emergency room at the hospital.
Luckily, Mona's blood loss had been minor, and she had no further complications. But that did little to allay her fears for the baby.
When they had told me that they needed to take the baby to ICU, I was scared. I was lifting heavy boxes. I was drinking. I wasn't taking my prenatal vitamins, and anything could be wrong with him. Knowing I got on the roller coaster right before I had my baby, it makes me really nervous. There's big signs saying that pregnant women should not be on them.
Vigorous amusement park rides during pregnancy pose a danger to pregnancy because of an increased risk of placental abruption, preterm labor, and possibly fetal death.
No, you weren't there. He hit his...
He could have hit his head so hard that he could have got brain damage and he could have died.
If a baby is dropped to the floor during a delivery, it can suffer a concussion or worse.
The family waited nervously for news.
I was scared. I was just hoping and praying that everything was okay with him.
Any news?
We're running some tests on him.
The most emotional part was my daughter. I had a feeling that she did something wrong. I guess I focused more on trying to keep my daughter calm.
They put me in a room that night. I didn't get to see him till the next morning. And they said everything was fine. He didn't have any problems. He was 7 pounds, 3 ounces. He was a healthy baby.